Another big hand, please, for the Sam Willows, and a big hand also for the motivators from Touch Community Services. Time to meet our four hosts for this evening. They've been regaling the audiences here for the last couple of hours. Let's bring them back with a lot of noise. Joachim Gomez, Ebi Shankara, Denise Tan, and Nurul Aini.
Good evening, Singapore. My name is Joachim Gomez.
Hello, Singapore. I'm Nurul Aini.
Hi, I'm Ebi Shankara.
And hello, my name is Denise Tan.
Yes, we are thrilled to be with you to celebrate Singapore's Golden Jubilee. And please, can we give a huge cheer to all the folks at the floating platform, Marina Bay, and also all the other celebration sites. Can we say hello? Hello!
Yes, and not forgetting our audience at home. You are important to us too. Hello, everybody.
Thank you for watching.
Now, Singapore, due to adverse weather conditions, sad to say the Red Lions will not be jumping, but we do care for their safety.
Absolutely. It's a real shame, but I think we can all agree that it's the safety of our Red Lions that always comes first.
So, guys, shall we get everyone acquainted with the Padang Wave again?
Yes, we should,
Abby. Yes, we really, really should. Are you guys ready for the Padang Wave?
Now, this time, we'll do things differently. Using our Singapore flags, we will start the Padang Wave. So people at home, we wish you were here. We're going to start from the west sector. From you guys, hold your flags on your right hand. You guys are going to start the Padang Wave for the people at home, as well as for the world to see. You ready? Here we go, on you! 1, 2, 3, go!
Coming to you, and go! Show them what you've got, Singapore!
Get ready, Mount South Sector! All right, Mount South Sector, you know where it's at, you know what to do!
Okay, we're gonna switch things up a bit. Now we're gonna start from here and we're gonna move to your right and we're gonna take it all the way back to you guys. If you're ready, in 3, 2, 1, up!
Go!
Let's go! Yeah! Let's go! Yes! South Sector! Let's go! Hands in the air, flags in the air! What an amazing spectacle, you guys! Are making Singapore look so good.
Let's go, North Sector! Make some noise!
And West Sector ended the wave. Here we go!
Woo! Yeah!
Thank you!
That's wow. Right. That's what's up.
You guys look awesome.
All right, so, you know, what's a birthday without a little bit of singing? And on our nation's 50th birthday, I think she deserves to hear us sing her happy birthday. So let's do this one more time, everybody. All right, on this note, happy. On the count of 3, 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Voices have warmed up. We have done the birthday song. Now, the next thing to do is the theme song. This year's NDP theme song. I know you guys know the chorus, so shall we sing along, Singapore?
Get your scarves
up. Get your scarves. Raise your scarves up. Now move it side to side together with us. Are you ready for this, Singapore?
People at home, sing along with us as well. You ready? In 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Scarves up.
Let's make some noise!
All right!
Smile. On 3, 2, 1, scars up. Here we go. Wave it.
Wave them high, Singapore.
As you can see behind us, marching into formation, behind us is the military tattoo led by drum major, military expert one, Muhammad Hafiz bin Amron, and the director of music this year is military expert for Jax Ansum Beng.
And absolutely, you know, the term military tattoo comes from a 17th century Dutch phrase, do den tap toe, which means turn off the tap. And the drummers would signify that they would have to tell the innkeepers to get the people to go back to the barracks.
All
so
right,
that's
Singapore.
What the tattoo's all about.
We're handing things back to Glenda and William. Take it away.
Well, thank you very much to our hosts, Abby, Neural, Denise, and Joachim.
And in case you're just joining us, welcome to NDP 2015, Bajula Singapura, our Golden Jubilee, live from the Padang.
Now let's put our hands together and welcome local singers, Fauzi Lily, Michaela Therese, Nathan Hartono, and Tabitha Nauza to sing a medley of two NDP favorites, We Are Singapore and Stand Up for Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Padang, Senior Ministers of State, Ministers of State, Senior Parliamentary Secretaries, and Mayors to the Padang.
Gentlemen, let us welcome our Deputy Prime Ministers and Cabinet Ministers.
We are
Ladies and gentlemen, announcing the arrival of Emeritus Senior Minister, Mr. Goh Chok Tong. He's accompanied by three signatories of the Independence of Singapore Agreement in 1965, Mr. Ong Kang Boon, Mr. Jek Yuen Tong, and Mr. Othman Wok. The Independence of Singapore Agreement was signed by 10 members of the then Singapore Cabinet.
From your heart, be prepared to give a little more.
Stand up for Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored to have with us foreign dignitaries who have come to join in the celebrations at the Padang for Singapore's 50th National Day.
Stand up for Singapore. This smile. If you stand up for Singapore, you'll find it all worthwhile. Believe in yourself, you've got something to share. So show us all you really care. Be prepared to give a little more.
Special welcome to all our distinguished guests, and thanks again to our singers Tabitha and to Michaela, also to Nathan as well as Fauzi. Thanks again, guys, for that rousing medley. Time now for our military tattoo performance put up by our very own SAF band, along with the Silent Precision Drill Squad, along with the performers from the Association of People with Special Needs.
Received its name back in 1994. Military music, however, has been instrumental to the mood of our parade and ceremony sections since our first National Day back in 1965. The band is accompanied by the Silent Precision Drill Squad. Introduced in 1984, they made their first appearance at the National Day Parade in that same year and have been dazzling the crowds ever since with their amazingly well-executed fire drills. Being part of the action are the members of the Association for Persons with Special Needs.
Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong. Prime Minister attended every National Day parade since we achieved independence. His absence today is sorely felt by all Singaporeans. National Day Parade 2015 will now feature a special tribute dedicated to our founding Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Kuan Yew.
It isn't easy building something out of nothing, especially when the road ahead's a rocky one. But if we gather all our courage and conviction and hold our dream up high, the challenge will be won. So now we look around us and we see a nation built with love by you and me. A land to treasure right down to the core. Our home, our heart, our Singapore. Whoa. 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 Our home, our heart, our Singapore. We've moved ahead together. We've built a brave new world where we could shine and grow. And now we only have to look towards tomorrow to carry on the dream as far as it will go. And amazing as it seems, it all started with a dream. And our dreaming isn't done, 'cause the best is yet to come.
I'm here today to express my thanks to Mr. Lee for the country that he has built.
We are hoping that things will turn better, you know, so that he can celebrate the our 50th birthday with us on the 9th of August.
When I see him, I always think of my grandpa, so yeah, I feel sad for this moment.
While we are saddened, we must also honour his spirit and what he has left behind for us and continue the good work that he has started.
So now we look around us and we see a nation built with love by you and me. A land to treasure right down to the core. Our home, our heart, our Singapore. Singapore. Ah, Singapore.
White Knights will now perform the Five Stars tribute flypass. Ladies and gentlemen, as the prologue for National Day Parade 2015 comes to a close, we embark on the story of Singapore with Chapter 1 beginnings. Let us travel back in time to witness the legendary arrival of Sang Nila Utama and his royal entourage, who sought safe refuge on the island Temasek and called it Singapura. Sang Nila Utama, who was said to have been a powerful ruler of the Sriwijaya Empire of Sumatra, was on a quest to conquer new lands to rule. With his fleet of ships, the legendary Sang Nila arrived at the Riau Islands, where he saw in the distance an island known as Temasek. According to legend, it was on our land that he spotted a lion, which in Malay is called Singa, thereby giving us our name, Singapura, or the Lion City. All were drawn by the potential offered by the island as a trading route. Immigrants came from far and wide. Traders, coolies, scholars, all braved hard conditions to seek adventure and opportunity. From many different lands crossed the seas to seek their fortunes in Singapore. Buoyed by hope and opportunity, they pressed on and found great success, building fortunes as businessmen and traders. They then brought in other members from their homeland and helped these new arrivals settle in to work towards a better future. They brought with them the culture of their homelands, leading to the beginnings of cultural diversity in Singapore.
As a community, the people worked to build a better future. There were struggles and setbacks. Life was hard, but the spirit of a nation began to take root, a people banding together for survival and prosperity. Soon, people from other lands arrived on our shores. Arab traders, Indian businessmen, and people from Malaya. The start of our multi-ethnic, multicultural society. With the arrival of Sir Stamford Raffles and the rise of Singapore as a trading port, merchants and traders flocked to the island. They sank roots here, building a multi-ethnic, multi-religious home for themselves. Sir Stamford Raffles arrived in Singapore in 1819. He was drawn to the island's strategic position at the southern tip of the Malay Peninsula. It was the ideal halfway point for sea trade from British India to China, possessing a natural deep harbor, freshwater supplies, and timber for repairing ships. Raffles set foot and worked to develop a township. He also saw to the education of the people, setting up an institution of higher learning known then as the Singapore Institution. Singapore had a population of 1,000 when Raffles arrived. 50 years later, by 1869, the population had grown to 100,000, with immigrants arriving to be a part of the exciting development of this new island. Many tumultuous years follow as Singapore strives to find its own voice, to formulate an identity before finally gaining independence in 1965. Before our eyes, the Victoria Theatre clock tower takes shape, a symbol of the passage of time as the nation moves forward towards the moment of independence in 1965.
There's nothing to be worried about. We are going to have a multiracial nation in Singapore. We will set the example. This is not a Malay nation, this is not a Chinese nation. This is not an Indian nation. Everybody will have his place. Equal. And as Singaporeans, we unite. Regardless of race, language, religion, culture.
Show is the Vintage Parade, which recreates the sights and sounds of the early street parades from the 60s to the 80s. This nostalgic parade features contingents from the 9 key organizations representing the different sectors across Singapore. We have the Singapore Armed Forces contingent consisting of pioneers from our Army, Navy and Air Force. These pioneers are part of the Singapore Armed Forces Veterans League, started in 1990 to foster the spirit of camaraderie among our servicemen. 6 members of this contingent took part in the very first National Day Parade in 1966. We have our police and SEDF veterans forming the combined contingent representing the Singapore Police Force and Singapore Fire Service. Our dashing veterans are sporting iconic vintage outfits. Singapore would not be as safe and secure today without their contributions. Coming in next with our colorful streamers is the People's Association contingent. These streamers were featured in the 1971 Street Parade and evoke fond memories for many. Utilities Board contingent. The PUB was set up in 1963 as a statutory board and reconstituted in 2001 as Singapore's National Water Authority. Over the last 50 years, PUB has built up a robust and diversified supply of water for Singapore. Following behind in blue tops and matching blue hats are POSB girls who formed the Vintage Post Office Savings Bank contingent. POSB was founded in 1877 and is affectionately known as the People's Bank. Next are our angels in white, helmed by nurses from SGH, KKH, and the various institutions and specialty centers in SingHealth. As they march past, we pay tribute to generations of nurses for their contributions in building up the nation's health. Next up is the PSA contingent. The Port of Singapore Authority was formed in 1964 as a statutory board and played a key role in our economic transformation. Today, PSA is a leading global terminal operator. Following behind is the Housing and Development Board contingent. Since its inception in 1960, HDB has provided affordable public housing for Singaporeans and helped to transform the urban landscape of Singapore. The last contingent is made up of ladies from our national carrier, Singapore Airlines, in their distinctive sarung kebaya uniforms. The Singapore girls are sitting in traditional trishaws, peddled by men from the 3rd Battalion Singapore Guards. We'll be right back. Liberation Parade and a nostalgic trip down memory lane. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in giving the participants a warm round of applause. And now look to the skies as our very own Singapore Airlines A380 is approaching the Padam, decked out in commemorative livery. Since its founding in 1972, our national carrier has become a household name all over the world, with a network spanning six continents. As we watch the A380 pass overhead, this is a fitting reminder of how far we have come as a nation. And with that, we turn to the next chapter of Singapore's story, which focuses on Singapore's remarkable progress and transformation over the last 50 years.
When we were young, life in the kampong was tough, but it's enjoyable. Although we don't have much, everyone laugh and cry together.
I was born in 1952. Singapore got its independence in 1965. We were more or less a very young country. At the age of 16, I got my first job as an office boy. I wanted to be someone who's better in life, and at the same time, ensure that my home is taken care of.
In 1982, I moved out from the kampong to HDB. I feel excited because this will be my home, my own home with my own family. At that time, Singapore was developing very fast. Everyone is learning how to survive.
I'm proud of Singapore, from where it has come to where Singapore is now.
From a little girl till now, 50, 60 years later, I think I grew together with my country.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Parade Regimental Sergeant Major for National Day Parade 2015 is Master Warrant Officer Chua Wee Gyan, Brigade Sergeant Major, 5th Singapore Infantry Brigade. Ladies and gentlemen, to celebrate our Golden Jubilee, This year's parade and ceremony features the largest number of participating civilian contingents. Marching in now from the rear of the Padang are the 16 contingents representing the social and economic pillars of our nation. Together, these civilian organizations and companies showcase how far Singapore has progressed, both socially and economically, over the past 50 years. Ladies and gentlemen, the parade commander will now take over command of the parade from the parade regimental sergeant major.
I joined the army in 1957 after I served the volunteers for 8 years. In 1966, I was assigned to be the first RSM of the National Day Parade. At that time, there's nobody else to do. During the parade, the sun was very, very hot. Nobody moved. The crowd cheering the parade during our march past.
And soon they came into view, our own defense forces. A sterling sight and a precision performance that was greeted warmly by the citizens.
The National Day to me is to celebrate for the country and to bring the people together and to show the people what we can do.
The journey has been long, but also very fulfilling. We have a lot of people coming from all walks of life. When I first saw everybody coming together, the entire parade, it was very inspiring. It's an awesome sight to behold.
People make you feel like coming every weekend. They have put in effort, they have put in a heart and soul to do and perform the best. Really the human spirit that come together to really want to do something for the nation.
Marching in now are the 32 regimental colors, the three state colors, and Guard of Honor contingents. The colors are military flags that originated as means of identification in battle. In the past, when colors were carried on active service, they stood as a rallying point and the scene of their last stand. The significance of colors today is more symbolic in nature. They are the embodiment of an institution's history, honor, and tradition. regimental sergeant major is military expert 3, Stephen Nodden. The Guard of Honor contingents are proudly formed by the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, and the Singapore Police Force. The parade commander this evening is Lieutenant Colonel Chu Jin Kiet Alvin, commanding officer, 1st Commando Battalion. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as the parade pays its compliment to our Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong. Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong will now take his seat. Prime Minister Lee is Singapore's 3rd Prime Minister. This is his 11th appearance at the National Parade as the country's Prime Minister.
Where dreams come true for us, where we walk together hand in hand towards a future so bright.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Clement Chow, Jacintha Bishaganaden, Douglas Oh, Dawn Yip, and Robert Fernando will now lead a medley of Count On Me Singapore and One People, One Nation. Please join in.
Happy birthday, Singapore! Now's the time to join with us with your loudest voice to sing these classic tunes. Together now, everyone.
We have a vision for tomorrow,
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise to welcome His Excellency, President Tony Tan Keng Yeon. Ladies and gentlemen, leading the salute to the nation, the Republic of Singapore Air Force will bring you an unprecedented spectacle. To celebrate our nation's golden jubilee, a thrilling 20 F-16 Fighting Falcons will enter the Padang airspace in a 5-0 formation. It is no mean feat for 20 F-16s to maintain precise formation at a speed of 600 kilometers per hour. This will be followed by Singapore's very own Black Knights, displaying utmost precision in the execution of the iconic bomb burst, presenting the salute to the nation. Now, the Black Knights bomb burst. And here they come! Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Mr. President, the parade is formed up and ready for your inspection, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, our president will now inspect the parade. As a mark of respect, the 25-pounder guns will fire in salute to the president. This year, the gun salute is executed by two artillery pioneers, namely Senior Warrant Officer Retired Lim Seng Wah and Senior Warrant Officer Retired Kutalingam Naina, together with gunners from the 21st Battalion Singapore Artillery on board the M3G floating rafts operated by the 35th Battalion Singapore Combat Engineers located at Merlion Park. Singapore's seventh president and was sworn in September of 2011. He has served Singapore since 1979 when he became a member of parliament. The president is stopping to compliment a soldier. The president's unhurried inspection of the troops is a courtesy he bestows on the guard of honor who has invited him to review the contingents. The presidential gun salute will fire 21 volleys as a mark of respect for the president as he inspects the guard of honor. The salute is fired from these 25-pounder weapons, which were brought to the Singapore artillery during the Second World War and were used by the British to defend Malaya and Singapore during World War II. Are mounted on the M3G, a military float bridge that functions as a mobile platform. This year, the PGS is anchored in the waters off Merlion Park, bringing it closer to the public that are gathered here at the Marina Bay.
The presidential ceremonial vehicle will now drive our president around the paddock. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and wave your flags to our president as the vehicle drives past you.
The parade inspection is a tradition that has been with us since the first National Day, which was incidentally held here in the paddock where the Declaration of Singapore's Independence took place. It is a joyous moment today as the crowds and contingents greet the president on Singapore's 50th birthday celebration. The connection between the head of state and the people reflects our multiracial society. Every one of us, young or old, regardless of our backgrounds, coming together to play a part in preserving the unity and harmony of this country we call home, just as we did 50 years ago. A reminder that the progress and achievements today stems from the efforts of individuals, just like us, who shared a common vision, forged a common identity, and moved forward towards a common goal. And that as a nation, we need that same pioneering spirit today, that same determination to work hard and persist as together we shape Singapore's future.
Thank you.
Mr. President, may I have your permission to proceed and thereafter march off the parade, sir.
President Tony Tan will now take his seat. This is President Tony Tan's fourth National Day as head of state. He is Singapore's seventh president. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've all been waiting for, the dynamic aerial display for our nation's Golden Jubilee. Get ready those cameras as you won't want to miss any of these spectacular maneuvers. Leading this year's National Day aerial flypast is the combined helicopter formation featuring the Seahawk, Apache, Super Puma, and Chinook helicopters. Watch them as they approach the Padang in an arrowhead formation. Following the helicopters, we have supporting pillars of RSAF's air, land, and sea operations, led by a Charlie 130 Hercules and two Fokker 50 aircraft. Now watch these tactical transport planes cruise over the Padang airspace in a VIC formation. Also in the arsenal of the RSAF, we have the KC-135 Stratotanker and a Gulfstream GE-550 airborne early warning aircraft. Now watch these magnificent machines soar across the Padang, escorted by four F-5 Tigers. Next up, two pairs of RSAF Black Knights will cross each other's flight paths at combat speeds, followed by another pair punching through the skies in a vertical climb. Presenting the Black Knights, Chris Cross. Showcasing the power and agility of one of the world's most capable multi-role fighter aircraft, one of the RSAF's F-15 SGs will now enter the Padang airspace and maneuver into a combat turn, followed by a steep vertical climb. Now watch the F-15 execute the high G combat turn. Look at the vortices on the wings of the F-15. This maneuver places high demand on the pilot as he sustains the high G-force. Presenting the F-15 Vertical Climb. Finally, three F-15 Eagles will now enter the Padang airspace and execute a flat burst. Watch the precise maneuver and feel the roar of the F-15 SG as they engage the afterburners. Happy birthday, Singapore! Thank you.
Yang, Yang Lai, Dulang, Sanja. Baris akan berjalan keluar dalam masa cepat. Kawalan kehormatan dahulu. Kawalan kehormatan ke kanan. Yang lain ke kiri dan ke kanan. Sing!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Colors Party is now forming up for the traditional march past, together with the four Guard of Honor contingents. 32 marching contingents are also featured in this evening's parade. They are formed by 5 contingents from the SAF and Home Team, 10 contingents from uniformed groups, 16 social-economic organizations, and the combined band. Together, the contingents represent the country's commitment to the 5 pillars of total defense: military, civil, social, economic, and psychological defense. In the fields of combat, training, administration, efficiency, and service to the community. Ladies and gentlemen, as a mark of respect, please rise as the Colors Party marches past you. Leading the march past is the parade commander, Lieutenant Colonel Tujin Kit Alvin. The 3 state colors are in the forefront, followed by the parade regimental sergeant major, Master Warrant Officer Chua Wee Gyup. Following behind are the 32 regimental colors, with the colors regimental sergeant major, military expert 3, Stephen Nardin. The Army Guard of Honor contingent is next, formed by men from the 1st Commando Battalion. It is led by Contingent Commander Major Vinod Kumar. We turn our attention now to the Navy Guard of Honor contingent, formed by men from the Naval Diving Unit. This contingent is led by Contingent Commander Major Brandon Chu. We now see the Republic of Singapore Air Force contingent, comprising men from the Air Power Generation Command. The 3rd Guard of Honor contingent is led by Contingent Commander, Military Expert 5, Mario Xie Shou Chai. Finally, the 4th Guard of Honor contingent is the Singapore Police Force contingent, forming the contingent of men from the Police Training Command of the Singapore Police Force and led by Deputy Superintendent of Police Alan Yue Kar Kyong. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, marching towards you is the contingent formed by the Army, led by Contingent Commander Captain Tan Chia Chia Daniel. Next, we have the Republic of Singapore Navy Contingent and the Republic of Singapore Air Force Contingent, led by Military Expert 4 Chia Wan Cheng Danny and Captain To Yun Chie. Keeping pace are the Singapore Police Force Contingent and the Singapore Civil Defense Force Contingent, led by Assistant Superintendent of Police Ong Chong Yi Andrew and Captain Yap Pin Yang Thaddeus. Next, we have the uniformed groups, leading the NCC Land Contingent and NCC Sea and Air Contingent are Cadet Lieutenant Carnavanthan and Cadet Lieutenant Lau Sin Wei. Behind them are the National Police Cadet Corps and National Civil Defense Cadet Corps, led by Cadet Inspector Ong Min Yi and Cadet Lieutenant Ho Mei Chi. Next, the Singapore Red Cross and St. John Ambulance Brigade, led by Assistant Youth Officer Yeo Min Chie and Corps Staff Officer Grade 5 Wong Yong Chien. The following two contingents are the Boys Brigade and Girls Brigade, led by Senior Cadet Lieutenant Quek Tsen Wei and Warrant Officer Sin Sui Yi. Finally, the last two are the Girl Guides and the Scouts, led by young adult Tan Li Mian Claudia and Venture Scout Narupon Naritana-san. Ladies and gentlemen, our social and economic groups are up next. Leading the way, we have MOE and NTUC, led by Mr. Ang Pao Chu and Mr. To Hok Po. They are followed by PAP and PCF, and One People SG, led by Ms. Ellen Lee Gekhoon and Ms. Musdalifa Binti Anwar. The third block of contingents comprise Sing Health and Changi Airport Group, led by Dr. Teo Mi Chi Mavis and Ms. Ng Lai Leng. Close behind them are Comfort Delgro and CWT, led by Mr. Rahmat Bin Hashim and Madam Lo Lien. The fifth block of contingents comprise DBS Bank Limited and High Flux, led by Mr. Malcolm Ko Yong Yi and Ms. Ivy Ng. They are followed by Keppel Group and Kopitiam, led by Mr. Zhou Leong Shi Shen and Mr. Alden Tan Xiang Hin. We now see the OSIM contingent and the Semcorp Industries Limited, Semcorp Marine Limited contingent, led by Mr. Alan Tan Beng An and Mr. Yam Ah Mi. And bringing this year's parade and ceremony to a close are Singapore Power and Singtel, led by Mr. Jeremy Ong and Mr. Sim Kok Leong Andrew. These are the final two socio-economic contingents. Music for the parade and ceremony is provided by the combined band.
The band comprises members from the Singapore Armed Forces Band, Singapore Police Force Band, National Cadet Corps Command Band, and the National Police Cadet Corps Band, and is led by band conductor, Military Expert 5 Philip Tung Liat Peng, and drum majors, Military Expert 1 Muhammad Hafiz bin Amran, and Sergeant Abdul Latif bin Abdul Rahman.
Everything was new for us. We were no camp. We don't have the training ground. When we brought the tank back from Keppel Harbor, we were told that this tank was to go into a National Day Parade. It was to show the strength of the defense. The preparation was really tough. Time was not with us, actually. We had to rush. We have to practice driving to make sure the tank work first in cross country, and then we practice driving along the road at Choa Chu Kang and Lim Chu Kang. When we drove the tank past, the crowd was there and they cheered. The sense of pride was there, you know. We were the first to have the mobile column of the nation. The 18 tank display really demonstrated the strength of the SAF. The future of Singapore depends on whole populations. We must all have the attitude to defend Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Golden Jubilee Mobile Column, representing the strength of our nation. Commanding this year's column is Lieutenant Colonel Lim Ka Kang. By his side is the second in command of the very first mobile column in 1969, Colonel retired Go Lai Chun. Leading the column, the Leopard 2SG is Singapore's very own main battle tank, equipped with awesome firepower, mobility, and armored protection. Our Leopards spearhead the Army's land maneuvers, dominating the battlefield with their speed and precision. Each tank is operated by a four-man crew. Their teamwork and coordination are essential in making our Leopard 2SG the best tank in the world. Following closely behind the Leopard 2SG is the Bionics 2 armored fighting vehicle, developed locally by ST Engineering. It is equipped with a 30mm cannon and can carry up to 8 troopers. Another variant is equipped with a heavy machine gun and automatic grenade launcher. Next up is the versatile Bronco all-terrain tracked carrier, designed to maneuver through various types of terrain for field and urban operations. The Bronco comes in several variants to meet a whole range of operational demands. Following behind behind the Bronco, the Terex infantry carrier vehicle provides infantry troopers with enhanced mobility, protection, and firepower, enabling them to maneuver to the battlefield quickly and safely. Behind the Terex is the light strike vehicle Mark II from the Guards. They are equipped with lethal weapons like anti-tank missiles and grenade launchers. Up next are Army Intelligence Troopers. They deploy the mini UAV to collect information on the battlefield. Now leading the artillery formation, we have the High Mobility Artillery Rocket System. Each of its GPS-guided rockets can achieve an accuracy of 10 meters and can be fired up to a maximum range of 70 kilometers. Next up, we have the Combat Engineers. Leading the packet is the brand new Armored Engineer Vehicle, which ensures that no obstacle stands in the way of our army. Other assets from the Combat Engineers include the Armored Vehicle Launch Bridge that enables heavy vehicles like the Leopards to cross wide gaps, the Trailblazer Countermine Vehicle, and the M3G Float Bridge, which ferries forces across water bodies. Rounding off this packet are our chemical, biological, radiological, and explosive forces, capable of an immediate response to chemical and biological incidents. From the signals formation, these vehicles facilitate communication between different units on the battlefield. The SATCOM vehicle is critical for transmitting data on the move. Now leading the Combat Service Support Command, we have the Tracked Maintenance Task Vehicle. It facilitates the repair of all our armored vehicles. Following closely behind are the Wheeled Maintenance Task Vehicle, the Fuel Tanker, and the Fully Integrated Transport Container. In this packet also, the newly designed combat ambulances that will support both peacetime and operational requirements. Next up, we have the ground-based air defense assets from the Republic of Singapore Air Force. These air defense systems like the Igla and Spider, as well as IHAWK, deploy missiles to destroy hostile aircraft. Rounding up the first segment, we have the Sergeant Major of this year's Mobile Column, Master Warrant Officer Chia Hai Tong.
SAF and the Home Team have conducted more than 30 overseas missions, ranging from peacekeeping and peace support to humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. Time and time again, our men and women in uniform have answered the call of duty at short notice, serving in foreign lands and seas, far away from home and loved ones. They work in harsh conditions, volatile security environments, and unfamiliar cultures, to play their part in providing clean water, medical and dental care, as well as building clinics, schools and bridges. This has made a huge difference to the lives of others. This is our strength in action.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the second segment, showcasing our strength in action. Leading the segment is Military Expert 5, C. Yen Ling, a military medical expert and veteran of multiple overseas deployments. On parade are assets that have been deployed overseas for humanitarian assistance as well as peacekeeping operations. These include the Arthur Weapon Locating Radar deployed in Afghanistan, the Water Purification Unit in overseas flood relief efforts, and the LARC 5 for Operation Flying Eagle in Aceh. Behind them is the Singapore Civil Defense Force's 5,000-liter heli bucket, which was deployed to fight forest fires in Chiang Mai. From the Republic of Singapore Navy, we have the Caister and Remus autonomous underwater vehicle. The Remus was used in the search for AirAsia flight QZ8501. The Scan Eagle unmanned aerial vehicle enhances our maritime surveillance. The Protector unmanned surface vessel supported operations in the Gulf of Aden. And making its debut appearance is the specialized marine craft. Fast and agile, it responds decisively against maritime security threats.
Since independence, our growth has been met with threats and challenges in the form of terrorism, civil disasters, and diseases. They often strike at a moment's notice, threatening our loved ones and our way of life. Each time, we have responded resolutely by pulling together as a nation and emerged from the storm stronger and more united. National agencies, private organizations and individual Singaporeans have each played their part, lending a helping hand to overcome adversity together. As we celebrate 50 years of nationhood, we must continue this spirit of strength and resilience. Whatever challenges lie ahead of us, we can rest assured that the SEF and Home Team are always ready to respond swiftly to any emergency, and that Singaporeans will rally together even in the toughest of times.
The third segment is titled Strength for Our Home, where we salute our security forces' vigilance in keeping Singapore safe. Making a grand appearance are the motorcycles, led by personnel from the military police, traffic police, and Singapore Civil Defense Force in an arrowhead formation. Look out for the newly acquired Peacekeeper Protected Response Vehicle, which provides stronger protection, accurate firepower, and better maneuverability in our island defense operations. Next up, we have vehicles from the Singapore Police Force with their new designs and logo. They patrol our streets every day to keep us and our homes safe. Our police officers dedicate their lives to maintaining order and upholding the law, with the vision of making Singapore the safest place in the world. Rounding up the third segment are vehicles from the Singapore Civil Defense Force. In the lead is the fourth generation light fire attack vehicle, affectionately known as the Red Rhino. It is the world's first compact urban firefighting vehicle with an integrated compressed air foam pump system that can extinguish fires four times faster than water. Following behind the ambulances is the SCDF's latest innovation. The Hazardous Materials Control Vehicle integrates three operational capabilities onto a single platform, namely the Central Command Center, the advanced diagnostic equipment, and two mobile transporters for enhanced detection and monitoring during an incident.
Over the past five decades, generations of Singaporean men and women have stepped forward to serve and defend our nation. It is their commitment to protecting Singapore that has provided us with 50 years of peace and stability. As we move onward, we cannot take the present stability for granted. Let us share with future generations of Singaporeans the importance of defense and security and prepare them to play their part in defending Singapore. Every single one of us must be committed to safeguard our homes, our loved ones, and freedom to choose our own way of life. Every generation of Singaporeans must fulfill this duty as we bring Singapore from strength to strength.
Ladies and gentlemen, rounding up the mobile column is our final segment, titled From Strength to Strength.
generations of Singaporean men and women have stepped forward to serve and defend our nation. It is our commitment to protecting Singapore that has provided us with 50 years of peace and stability. Mounted on these vehicles are nine families who have proudly served the nation across generations. They represent our unwavering commitment to defense. Let's show our appreciation to them, as well as to all Singaporeans who have served in the SAF and the home team in the past and present. You are the strength of our nation. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause to our Golden Jubilee Mobile Column.
My heart is torn from the start.
My parents, who came from Tamil Nadu, which is in India.
I was the second generation. We were given birth here.
My paternal grandfather is Javanese.
Both my parents are Hokkien, like of Hokkien roots, descent.
We are all both Teochews.
Same for our family members. Yeah. Our parents are all Teochews.
China குடும்பத்துல பிறந்தேன். ஆனா வந்து ஒரு மாசத்து பிள்ளையா இருக்கும்போது தூக்கி தமிழங்கள்ட்ட கொடுத்தவாசி எனக்கு தமிழ் தான் தெரியும், எனக்கு சீனா தெரியாது.
My dad is Chinese, my mom is Indian.
So I suppose technically people will say I'm Chindian.
It would have been really odd if we were called Innies.
I can speak little words from different languages.
I try to act like I can speak Mandarin sometimes.
Mana.
Mana, 你去哪里走到哪里去?
Oh.
Mandarin means thank you.
我可以称呼一点点.
Satu dua tiga, maybe up to tiga.
Selamat makan.
Ni apa?
Kongsi pacai.
我爱你.
Muneruvaliba.
Muneriendo.
Yolo. 他的意思是 you only live once.
Yeah, I know 小茶包.
That means crazy girl.
Yeah.
The one thing that I really cherish most about Singapore is really the racial understanding and the harmony that we have.
I hope that Singaporeans can still continue to interact with people in their different languages, because I think that's part of our identity.
Use our differences as something that ties us and not something that separates us.
Doesn't matter what race, what age, what language.
We celebrate each other's festival.
I think that's what makes us Singapore. That's what I love about our diverse racial landscape.
国国情情热热快乐
Happy National Day.
Joined by the performers from the Singapore Soka Association in a show of Singapore's unity. and the first formation, the words Tuanjie, the Chinese characters for unity, a reminder of the unity and social harmony we enjoy now and for years to come. We have it, the word progress, to capture Singapore's remarkable development over the years. Formation Vetri, the Tamil word for victory. How we have successfully forged a nation that continues to build on its successes. But even as we celebrate our successes, as a nation, we continue to look forward to continuously overcoming challenges as we grow and develop as one people. Beautiful formation of orchids, the Vandamis Joachim, the national flower of Singapore, a hybrid chosen for its resilience and year-round blossom. The orchid is symbolic of the spirit of the Singapore people, a resilient nation that continues to press on towards a brighter future. Final formation, Majula, the Malay word for onwards, urging our nation to press on in the years ahead. The four words in our various languages embodying our common values and ideals, forming the message, in unity we progress towards success. Onwards Singapore.
Sarajevo.
We are calling from Beijing.
Geneva, Switzerland.
I want to eat nasi lemak. I want to eat
rojak.
Char kway teow.
I miss laksa.
really all this comfort food, you know, like porridge in the morning.
There's always food available in Singapore, whatever the time is.
Being Singaporean is very unique and very special. It's like you have the ability to recognize one another.
Like they will say like a lot of Singlish, like you can tell, you can hear.
Immediately you feel this intimacy with them.
And I'll just go straight to the him or her and just like, hey, hello fellow Singaporean, I just wanted to say hello.
Singaporeans queue up for no reason, just to find out what the queue is about.
Even overseas, they're queuing up. So I think that's our pastime. National pastime is queuing up.
You always go to the one with the longest queue because you think that tastes the best.
Only when I'm here, I realise the virtue of queuing up. Because people over here don't queue up.
They like to choke tables with tissue paper.
I've seen water bottles and
occasionally umbrellas.
Yeah.
Kiasu. I would say efficient.
I would never like judge anybody for being kiasu anymore because I realize I'm also very kiasu.
I think I will miss watching National Day Parade on the TV.
I wish we could be home celebrating this special day with my family.
We're having celebrations here too.
Yay!
Happy birthday, Singapore! Woo!
Happy birthday, Singapore!
Happy birthday, Singapore!
Happy birthday, Singapore!
Happy birthday to you!
And together with the performers from the People's Association, we take a look at the things that make us Singaporean. First on our list, food. After all, Singapore is known worldwide as a food paradise. Indeed, our multi-ethnicity has led to the wide variety of culinary cuisines we enjoy locally.
Bandung. Bandung. Chicken rice. Fish bowl noodles.
Nasi goreng, very nice. That's a speciality. 99 varieties. Fried rice paradise. Showcase how it's been described. Booked a table, very wide. That is what I would do. Fried rice paradise. Showcase how it's been described. Booked a table, very wide. That is what I would do.
These are the people of Singapore.
I'm gonna pass it on. Spread it all around. Touch someone with a thought that counts, 'cause courtesy begins with me.
And that opening line, a reminder of the many campaigns in the early 80s and 90s that helped Singapore in her efforts to become a more gracious and cohesive society, everyone living in harmony.
These are the people of Singapore.
And the prudent use of water, a precious national resource.
Being busy at work is being busy at school. Your body is sticky, you need water to cool. A 5-minute shower is all you need. So let's all dance to the shower beat. Yeah.
And there on the field, a formation of a tap with water dripping from it. Our safe water campaign is as relevant today as it was back then.
Kids are in bed. Let's now watch fireworks. Let's make it best.
Yeah.
Singapore. Baby, bro, I know you want it. So does the STU.
It's so easy to love your ride. You to get on and move it. Move it inside.
When you take the bus, your face is sour like banana.
The driver's seat already, he cannot tahan.
No aircon.
You're pushing and you're shoving. Don't care for one another. Howl like that.
something that is truly Singaporean. What's Singlish? And there, rings on the field around all the icons, representing how the different aspects of our unique identity ties us together. With a theme song from Mutt Yo-Yo, we revisit some of our well-loved TV hits. And on the field now, famous landmarks we've grown up with. Flowing through the formation of a river, reminding us how our country's development began from a central town along the Singapore River. Gentlemen, Kareem.
Singapore, with every generation, there
finally, tree formation, representing our rootedness and sense of belonging to Singapore as a people with a unique identity.
What do you want to be when you grow up next time?
I want to be a pilot when I grow up.
I want to be a policeman.
Doctor.
A fireman.
When I grow up, I want to be a ballerina.
A football player.
I want to be a teacher.
Reporter. I want to be an architect.
So that I can design buildings, flats and MRT stations.
Help people when I grow up.
Why you want to be a teacher?
Because I want to teach everybody.
We can protect the forest.
We can protect the forest.
I want to be a soldier when I grow up so I can protect Singapore.
I want Singapore to be a better country.
Nice and clean.
It will be a garden city.
And no rubbish around Singapore.
I want Singapore to have a lot of rainbows.
A better place for people to live in, and my friends are here.
We move onwards now with this spirited and fun item brought to us by some primary 3 and 4 students. Based on bright colors and energetic movements, the item reflects our emotional journey in overcoming challenges and to arrive at a conviction on which to build a brighter future. Period of uncertainty and confusion here, much like the doubts we have even as we strive to achieve greater heights for the future. Can we move ahead, taking with us the hopes and dreams of a nation? With that sudden change of lights, we see red stick figures. The red lights and fast movements representing the passion of our youths as they strive towards their aspirations for the next 50 years. Now, a sea of blue. Tension builds as Singapore progresses and faces challenges of a global nature. In a more open society, we need to be flexible and anticipate the challenges ahead. And now green. The positive energy of our youth as they lead us to fulfill bigger dreams for a brighter tomorrow. Finally, a bright white for the confidence and commitment as we face the future together. We move onwards. Majula Singapura.
Especially when the road ahead's a rocky one. But if we gather all our courage and conviction and hold our dream up high, the challenge will be won. So now we look around us and we see a nation built with love by you and me. A land to treasure right down to the core. Together, We built a brand new world where we could shine and grow. And now we only have to look towards tomorrow to carry on the dream as far as it will go.
Formation of our beautiful city skyline formed by primary 3 and 4 students, with 50 bright stars dotting the sky above, one for each year of Singapore's independence. Adding more glitter to the night, tiny stars carried by primary 1 and 2 students from Anderson Primary and Bukit View Primary. Together, our children, our hope for the future.
I think the one thing that I cherish about Singapore is the kampung spirit we have. I wish that that kind of community spirit would actually remain within us for a very long time to come.
I was born here, I grew up here. I see the transformation from the colonial time to now.
With no natural resources, we have progressed so much.
I think stability that was very hard earned and is built on the blood, sweat and tears of our forefathers.
The future of Singapore is not something that happens to us. It's something that we, the citizens, can create.
We can all do our part for a kinder and more inclusive Singapore.
To build a more equitable society, a just society.
What will our next 50 years be like? I say, it depends on you. Make the most of what you have. Chase that rainbow. Show the world what Singapore can be.
Singapore. This is home, true.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us unite in a new spirit, and as one nation, let us reaffirm our commitment to our beloved Singapore. Can we all please rise and say our national pledge together?
Justice and equality, so as to achieve happiness,
a magnificent view from the Bay Area at one altitude at Raffles Place. The largest ever, the most stunning display of fireworks in the history of Singapore as we celebrate our Golden Jubilee. A grand spectacle lighting up our city skyline, encouraging every Singaporean to press on towards an even brighter tomorrow. Majula Singapura!
What an incredible night this has been! Aren't you glad you were part of Singapore's Golden Jubilee celebration? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, our president will now take his leave. Can we say a big thank you to him and send him off with a huge round of applause, Dr. Tony Tan Keng Yam. Thank you, Mr. President.
Fantastic. So now we look around us and we see a nation that we love by your name. A land to treasure right down to the core. Our home, our heart, our Singapore.
This is how we started. This was how we're gonna end. Wave those flags in the air, Singapore! Happy birthday!
We're all part of one giant entity! Probably the biggest dog you're ever gonna be in! So hang on and celebrate!
It's 15 years of excellence, Singapore! Wave it! Ha!
I'm gonna go. evening to festivities to celebrate Singapore's 50th birthday.
Thanks for having us on as part of a very historic evening. Hope you have a wonderful evening, Singapore. I have one more thing to ask you. Do you have any energy left? Do you have any energy left?
Yes, we do, William.
All
yes,
right, three cheers for the next 50 years. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Majula.
Singapore.